Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls through Daggerfall. We are going to be responding to a summons by Lady Brisienna. I keep forgetting their names, like getting the names all mixed up. And I think this was the parchment note. Where is it? Somewhere in here. And yeah, finding it is going to be a bit of a trouble, to be honest. I just wish that quest items would stack, or at least there would be like a filter. The UI could definitely use a lot of work in Bethesda titles, to be honest. Not just Arena, the UI was pretty nice, and Lockbook worked as intended as well. In Daggerfall, nothing even stacks, so yeah. Grimfangs, come advance to Merwood in Bayrest. I will be waiting at the Fox and the Fairy for you. The fate of the Empire could be at stake, Lady Brisienna. So this is essentially Lady Brisienna's summons, and we will be responding to her summons, and going all the way to not Bolivia, but Bayrest, Merwood, first of all. And of course, by ship it will take us 7 days' time. And let's get up a high horse here, because it's a small town envy. And Fox and the what? Well, the fox and the something, they aren't fox and the fairy, right? This very inn itself. And we are supposed to meet Lady Brisienna in here. And see what she has to say. Where's the door though? The sign is here, so the door right here. And there's Lady Brisienna standing right there, and the game is lagging for whatever reason, as it tends to do sometimes inside of taverns. Let us go ahead and talk to her, see what she has to say, tell us. Grimfangs, I'm glad you could meet me here. The Blades and your Emperor need you again. And, sorry, I sort of had to cough there. Let me restart again. Grimfangs, I'm glad you could meet me here. The Blades and your Emperors need you again. Seriously, I mean, I just got done questing. I thought I completed both of the Emperor's requests, but alright, if you say so. You may or may not be aware that the Totem of Tiber Septim has been found. For a very brief time, Lord Woodborne of Fairest had it. Where he got it from is still a mystery. The Blades mounted an assault upon Woodborne Hall to retrieve it. Although the hall fell, many of our number fell with it. We sacked the Woodborne Hall. I thought I took care of most of the denizens there. What's going on, Lucianna? Are the Blades just that incompetent? We sacked the Woodborne Hall, but the totem was gone. I have reason to believe that Gothryd has the totem. The Blades no longer have the men to mount an assault on Castle Daggerfall. You have shown yourself to be quite adept at getting in and out of these spaces. Would you go into Castle Daggerfall and retrieve the Totem of Tiber Septim? Okay, I see what's going on here. Alright. Raiding Castle Daggerfall it is now. It seems that invariably, somehow or the other, if we are to play the main quest as we are supposed to play it, then we are gonna end up raiding all the main, you know, castles in the three main kingdoms anyway. So the reason that the totem disappeared from Woodborne Hall is pretty simple. One needs to be of royal blood, belong to the blood of Tiber Septim to actually use the totem. And to that effect, even Godfog is sort of, a legitimate person who is allowed to use it. How we get there, I have no idea. I don't know what kind of fuckery Tiber Septim did with the orcs, but or somebody, you know, higher up in that line. But somehow Godfog can use the Totem of Tiber Septim. I don't know how that works. Don't ask me. Anyhow, yeah, sure. I knew I could count on you, Grimfangs. The totem is most likely in the Daggerfall treasury. It is a huge room, quite unmistakable. I'm leaving in a couple of days. I shall send word to you where you can meet me after you get the totem. Should you succeed, the Emperor has instructed me to gift you with an artifact of great power and renown. Warlock's Ring. Uh-huh. Whatever that does. And alright, to Daggerfall it is then. Let's just take time to equip our axe instead and put this into the wagon. I want to level up my axe for the time being. I'll be using my swords when I get to. Well, I won't spoil it for you, but pretty much to the final dungeon. The good part right now is the fact that we are, completely through with all the side missions and side grinds. So from here on out, it's like we don't even need to wait since we are at an eligible level. I think I'm level 16 right now. So yeah, I think the final quest should be quite easy for us, and we don't really need to wait around or anything either. There's the castle again. I think it's on this side here. We need to go northeast. That is where we were headed anyway. So yeah, we just go like full blast at this point. A straight sprint to the finish. There's nothing else distracting us, nothing else that we need to cover from a roleplay perspective. Just, march on to the end of the main quest, and that's all we have. Now the thing is, this quest in itself is called Totem, Who Gets the Totem by UESP, and a lot of people are eligible for it. You can give the totem to a lot of people. You will also get like letters and stuff from people inviting you to give them the totem. Lady Brisienna, of course, has first dibs on it, but whether you actually get the totem or give her the totem or not is totally up to you. You do not have to if you do not feel like it. And yeah, pretty much that. However, I have been torn about whether to give the totem to the Emperor, or as should be done, or to Godwalk, so that he may be able to claim a place as his own, state. However, the fact of the matter is, based on whatever I saw the past few playthroughs about Godwalk's involvement with not just Woodborne but also a listener, he might just actually have been involved in King Lysander's death. And yeah, that is the promise I made to this guy is one that I'm going to break. And I do recall, I don't remember if this was the room or that was the room. Either of them were the rooms, but at any rate, we unsheathe our weapon and we start attacking. Night died. Time for you guys to die. Now, the reason I'm killing you is the simple fact that you guys are going to attack me otherwise. This person was unawares. Probably because I didn't enter any rooms, is why. That guy did not activate right up until his death. Which is sort of sad. I can't carry any more stuff. I literally just deposited all my gold. What's weighing me down so much? Honestly, it's sort of a mystery at this point. But yeah, one of these roads will take us to where we want to go. I'm just looting them for anything of value. Most likely, what I'm looking for the most are these gauntlets, Mithril gauntlets. Even though, it does say give me a rating of 19 here, which is essentially the same rating that these pauldrons give me, which is strange. Anyhow, these are Sysander's chambers. Oh wait, there are like a couple of rooms up there, aren't there? I think there are like a couple of rooms up there as well that we can check out. Now the reason that I'm taking these guys out is, well, quite simple. They'll become an issue, a thorn in our side later, otherwise. And this knight is not aggressive right up until the end. I sort of feel bad for slaying them at this point. But I know that as soon as I open one of these doors, they will attack us. Battle mage is dead. Of course, we cannot take any of their gold. Now, these are amazing. Daedric Greaves, however, we already have Daedric Greaves, which look cooler and are still new. So I don't think we'll be needing any of these anytime soon. Yeah, they aren't even attacking me. I'm just going around killing them and they aren't even attacking me. I'm a common citizen in their eyes. I don't know what's going on. Now, typically this would be the point where people start attacking me, but since there's nobody alive to attack me anymore, nobody will be attacking me. And this is the dungeon section of the game. I can hear orcs, which is quite strange. That is the last thing I expected to hear from Castle Daggerfall, actually. Now, from what I remember, from what I read in the articles, like ages ago, when I spoiled the game for myself, I remember that we had to go into some sort of an underwater area, and I think that area is right in front of us. I think this is pretty much the treasure room that they're talking about. You know, I think this guy fell down. I'd always wondered why this room is structured as such. I think it makes more sense now. And the game is lagging. Why is it lagging? Probably just OBS issues, I guess. But yeah, I'd always wondered why this room is the way it is, and I guess it makes more sense now. Now that I read it, and this might just be the treasure room that we're looking for. Why is the game lagging though, is what I wonder. There aren't any bridges here. I guess the only way for us to go anywhere is to pop in a potion of levitation, as is the case in these, instances, with this dungeon module at least. Now this looked like it had some sort of a strange glow to it, to be honest. Yeah, I was coming down to fight you, don't worry, I'm not gonna leave you behind. I'm gonna make sure you're dead before I proceed elsewhere. There's another orc shaman up there. We'll get you too. You just need to be patient and wait your turn. Excuse me, why are we lagging so much? That's a very valid question, and yeah, there are like graphical glitches all over the place. I think it might have something to do with now, if I recall correctly, that area is also treasury, but I want to be a little careful when going there. I don't want to touch the floor, otherwise it sort of damages me. And yeah, I want to get out of this room now that I've confirmed the contents. Good thing is I'm still not touching the floor, because touching the floor in that room, for whatever reason, will damage you. I'm just gonna explore all the sites. There are orcs inside this castle, and I suppose that's why Woodborne said that it's now up to Gothryd to essentially see things further, because I suppose it's like a joint plot between Gothryd, Woodborne, and what's his name? Gothwog. Excuse me? What's happened? Okay, something happened. Maybe I pressed the Windows key or something? I don't know, something happened. Nothing here. I sort of got happy there that I chanced into the objective room that easily, but I guess I did not. Yeah. That's what happened. Okay, might as well, since I did remember reading something about underwater areas. Water breathing though is what we really need, and right here. So water walking is essentially... That's I think a lamia. Nothing here, nothing that I can see here. So water walking is essentially levitation for well, let's go up. Let's go upstairs first. Let's clear out whatever's up there. And then we can come back here. Oh, we were already there. This part just hadn't rendered in. Oh, I didn't come close enough to look see the stairs. That's what happened. So yeah, water walking is essentially levitation for underwater. It increases your movement speed greatly. Rock has nothing to fear from me, not for long. It will learn to fear me. Nothing here. Looks like we need to pop in another potion of levitation then. And figure out where to go next. Typically, sometimes that location right there is where some of your quest objectives might spawn. Might, not always, just might. Let's pop in a potion of levitation and fly up to that same platform again. Although I feel like popping in potions of levitation is not the right play here, but since we are using up a lot of resources, which we will be requiring later, in the final dungeon of the game is... there is a juncture where you'll require levitation, and lots of it, mind you, to get through. Rats! Amazing. There's another door on the other side that we need to remember, and we don't go all the way to the left side of this room here, because that is trapped. I mean, it is booby-trapped. If you open the map, you'll notice that there's a like gaping hole right there. And that hole is essentially... wait, was there anything in here? Nah, no totem here. Wait, I thought there was a hidden door here. No? Okay, just my mistake. My bad. Yeah, that's all there is at this point here. Levitation. What do I do about you? Can't live with you, can't live without you. Can't adventure with you, can't adventure without you. And the levitation spell is also fading. Wait, did we... yeah, I guess we did not go all the way over to that end. I was wondering how we've already visited that area, because I don't recall ever visiting that area. Is this the throne room? This will bring the... oh, buddy, hi. But no, this is not the treasury. I mean, it's not supposed to be the treasury. What is this? Elven quarters, that looks amazing, honestly. There's supposedly somewhere here another rock warlord. So many warlords. So yeah, if anything, the presence of orcs in all of these areas more or less just guarantees Gothwalk's participation in all this. Now, the reason that I flipped that switch is because this puts that bridge there and allows us to cross this entire chasm. But before we go... yeah, that is... I was not trying to do that, but okay. I'll take it. Whatever it is worth, I will take it. Nothing here. And as far as I know, there's only one door here. Ox Shaman is dead. Of course, I can't carry anything. Why do I even bother checking? I have no idea. But there's a gap behind this thing here. Meaning that it is a moving thing. This platform is a moving thing. So it's like different entrances into the dungeon. There's not only just one entrance. Or maybe there is only one entrance and we just lucked into it. Or maybe these are like all different dungeons. I can't carry any more since we have all that we could ask for, I'll give up on the idea of carrying it all together. Okay, there's like a way down. Let's go down first. There are human guards. Now, human guards, I anticipate being here. But, orcs, that's like a clear sign of Godfog's involvement with, what's his name? Okay, I see. Do I want to? Might as well, right? Successful backstab on the rat. I can hear a Lamia, and their laughs sort of creep me out. Honestly. Just some loot here. Open sesame. So, what I wonder is, without any magical ability, how does my warrior know the difference between magically held lock and one that's, well, just a typical lock like this? Questions that remain unanswered. My axe skill is improved, so that's a good thing, I suppose. That's where we came from. Let's go further this way. Let's see where this leads us. Now, the thing is, since I remember the fact that we had to go into an underwater area, I'm not really gonna shy away from them. If I notice an underwater area, I will go get inside it. If it is just to see what lies beyond it. Warrior dead. Which is amazing. Now, I wonder if we actually came out the same way that in the same tower, essentially. Yes, it does seem like we have come out in the same tower area as before. Just that we haven't completely explored it yet. Now, I want to go down there first and check out whatever this area has to offer. Like I said, there are underwater areas here, and I don't plan on shying away from this thing. Is a trap, but the next area though should not be a trap, so. Levitation, healing, water breathing, water walking, and water breathing right next to each other. I wish the potions would stack, make things so much easier. Arena had stacking. I don't know why this game doesn't have that. It's like, this game just forgot all about stacking, you know? That's a nymph. Sorry, a trick. Whatever that is. I know the difference between nymph and a trick. Trick. If that is even how you pronounce those names. That's a Lamia. I don't know how strong these guys are, but apparently not really as strong from the looks of it. There's a cage here, but nothing inside these cages. I just quickly want to check if there are any hidden doors in this room. There is one. And I think we access it through the hidden door here. No. Oh, right. She opened the hidden door for us. This woman here. This Lamia here. And it doesn't really have anything apart from loot, which we can't carry any more of. So it's sort of pointless to be even trying to loot anything. Wait, where did the... Right here. Alright. Back to the top we go. We might be burning through our... how do I put this? Burning through our potions of water breathing and water walking. Thankfully though, we have lots of it saved up over time. We can go upstairs and check, but before that I would just like to clear out this area if it has anything. Okay, it seems like we're now back to what is apparently the main dungeon of the game. Because the music suddenly changed to like more royal mood. What was that? Is it like frost music? Frost magic, rather? Okay, it's like a goddamn congregation in here. Well, congratulations, you just blew up your own comrades in the process. These guys were tough, I'm not gonna lie. Enemies nearby, so you know what, let's just try going back to back a few pieces and resting here. No, of course not. Let's just use like a potion of healing and touch on this thing. I realized I haven't saved here in a while, so I haven't saved in this dungeon at all, actually. So might as well go ahead and do that. I don't know why I even tried to pick up the gold. It's practically useless to me, and I can't even pick it up anyway. Like, pick up any reasonable amounts of it anyway. Like a random congregation. Now this looks like a treasury, to be honest. I wonder how many hidden doors there are here. None from the looks of it. Just one to a front and one to a right. The lock apparently has nothing to fear from us. Somebody's trying to shoot some spells at us. I don't know who it is, but somebody's trying to shoot some spells at us. And the mood instantly changed to a more dungeon crawl. More of a dungeon crawl, so I don't know what's going on here. It's like that specific part was actually a part of... oh wait, let me switch interaction modes. Although it doesn't really matter, to be honest. I just want to check out if that side is also like a tunnel. Or whether this is like... this is like a storeroom. Yes, it is a storeroom. Good thing we got that cleared out. Okay, we're back here. Actually, we're here from the other side now. Typically, this is where a dungeon entrance is, if this would have been a dungeon. But this is not a dungeon, so... We don't have like a dungeon entrance right there. I mean, technically this is a dungeon, it's just not a... You know, this is not the entirety of the dungeon, is what I'm trying to say. Until fully healed, of course. Let us rest. I'm healed, cool. Nothing here. Unless... Nope, nothing. Nothing here. No hidden doors or anything either. Two parts here. Let's go, let's take a right. Now the dungeons in Daggerfall are honestly not that large. They can get pretty large, but ultimately you'll explore all of it within like 2 or 3 hours at most. So it's not like large to the point where you have to optimize your gameplay sometimes. Ooh, I like that. I'll put this into your inventory and I'll take this from yours. I like the look of that. I mean, it's Daedric, but it's got a trim to it. So let me go ahead and save in that regard. It's like when I don't need it anymore, I'm getting like tons of Daedric left pauldrons. But when I did need it, I didn't get it as much. I thought I heard like a door opening. Ah, this room. I'm guessing there are, Ox Shamans, multiple of them, at any rate. We just keep moving around until the other dude's invisibility wears off. And then we go ahead and try and attack him. I don't know where the dude can be, but I'm just gonna stick here. See, this is the problem with invisible enemies. They're impossible to notice. Unless that guy's stuck like on one of those. Yeah, this might be where the guy is. Nope. Just one of them here. Strange. The orcs at least have like pretty good loot, so. Okay. A Daedra right there. Don't know if I wanted to touch that skull or not, but probably should have saved before I touched it. That was an oversight on my part. One that will hopefully not be occurring again. We have already been here. While we're here, I guess it makes some sense for us to clear out this other room as well, at the other side, that we haven't been to previously. Let's go ahead and do that then. Somebody's blasting spells at us. I can't tell who it is. They might just be here. And more often than not, areas where you're actually supposed to go in these royal castles and stuff are marked with those dungeon banners. So maybe we were going the correct way up until now. ₹160 gold pieces, which I could pick up, which is amazing, if you ask me. Overriding the savior. Hi. At this point, I'm sort of convinced that I'm going the wrong way, but oh well. Who really cares? And we are currently back in various non-dungeon territory, from the looks of it. Was there like a hidden door somewhere along that route? No, there was not. No hidden doors here. Yeah, look at that. Something's tossing spells at us. I can't tell who it is. Look at that. Something is trying to toss spells at us. I think it might just be an imp of some sort. Torch. Nothing. Again, nothing in this torch either. Okay, so any sections that we have left unattended? We did cover that section, yes. I wish that Daggerfall would start rendering walls from the other side as well. Okay, so this area we have not covered yet, so let's go there. We take the right, and then we go through here. Did we take a left here? We have not taken a left here, actually. Might as well. Let's check out this room first. Two bots here, and an orc warlord without a cape this one. Ooh, I see you had an orcish weapon. That is amazing. Nothing of use for me though. Is this that area with the balcony? I don't know, honestly. The area is clear. Just some loot on the floor, nothing else. Now, right now I'm running because I have the stamina to spare. If I did not, I would not be running. This is the way where we are yet to go, right? Yes, yes it is. The thing about Daggerfall's 3D engine is that despite it being one of the first 3D engines ever, chameleon form not exactly something that I want to get. I don't even know how it works, to be honest. There's another set of stairs leading upstairs. We can either take this or, well, this is a dead end. So, nothing here. All right, up the stairs it is, I suppose. There's this little hole up there that we can use to go somewhere. And this has apparently led us to a place that where we have already been before. Now, we've got two choices here. We can either continue going straight or we can climb up this hole and check whatever's there. I elect to do the former. Oh, sorry. And while I'm doing it, I also want to check something else out. Oh, okay. Yeah, we can't exactly climb sideways while we're scale the wall sideways while we're climbing up. Have you been here before? Not from the looks of it, no. Since there is a banner here. A vampire. Okay, now this is making me a little nervous, although I have been saving potions for vampire ancients and stuff, so. Of all the things to find inside Daggerfall's crypts, how did they live here? Okay, I think we came back. Yes, we did. So, this is the area where we were, and something tells me we have completely toured this area to its fullest as well. No, there's like this pathway here that we have not covered. So, shall we go ahead and cover that then? I suppose. Oh, right. Right, I forgot that we took like a little detour there. I completely forgot about that. But no, there's like this place down there that we left behind. Let's go back to... Where did we come from again? yeah, let's go back to this hole in the wall that we sprung out of, and we'll continue from there. Yeah, that way. So we go up the steps and right. And we take a right here. Yes, we do take a right here. Unless... I mean, we have not really checked out that side, so might as well, right? I doubt that anything is here, but like there's anything of value here, but I suppose it does not hurt to check. Another vampire, which is a strange sighting in these areas. Good thing though is that I'm not hearing any vampire ancients. Those guys make a lot of noise. They hiss like cats all over the place. Do you have anything of value? I cannot pick up your gold. Alright. So, back down we go then. Alright, straight. Straight, right? I think so. Yes, straight. Straight it is. One of these routes is supposed to take us back upstairs. Unless, yeah, I suppose it would not, for the dungeon layout in this section is quite different. I think this is just going to take us out of, on the other side, from the looks of it, from whatever I can see. Good thing I slayed all the warriors there. Thank you for opening. And just imagine them looking at us waltzing out like that, among like a horde of dead bodies. Okay, so what other place have we not covered then. I mean, we could go back to this side and cross the bridge and get to the other side again. I suppose that can be done. For that though, I mean, there are a few ways to achieve that. We can just take the right here, and we can either like take the long way around, or we could, yeah, you know what, let's take this right here because we have not explored that side yet, so might as well do that while we're at it. I just hope that the main room that we were in is not actually the treasure room, like the main room that we literally chanced upon the first chance, bounced into the first chance that we got, is not the actual treasure room that we are looking for. Because if it is, then we are terribly lost at this point, and we'll probably have to revisit some of these areas again. But there are two parts here, one of them has a banner, one of them does not. Okay, underwater area. Sorry, not that. Resist, not resistance, I need... water breathing and water walking. That's water walking right there, and water breathing I think is right above it. Yes. Alright. There's like a ghost right here. Another, of course. Good thing I have a potion of reaction handy. Ghost aside. But the cool thing about the potion of reaction is that its effects will last even after your, you know, like, you don't, if you get paralyzed again, you don't really need to pop in like another potion of reaction or anything. The effects last, so it's like a preemptive, you can pop it in preemptively as well. Good thing about this game though is that it does not have any verbal components. Like, the spells in this game don't have any verbal components to them, so you can effectively pop in all the, like, even if you're paralyzed, you can still use your spells. Okay, this was a dead end. Nothing here, so I guess we keep heading forwards then. I would like to rest here for a while. I'm healed, swimming and axe have improved. Well, I suppose whatever helps them. Loot on the ground, which I did not place there, because I've stopped doing that. Some random things on the ground. Maybe we headed the right way. Difficult to tell at this point, but apparently not. This is just a dead end room. Like, that's pretty much what I was talking about when I was talking about the advantage of speed. The fact that you can get off so many shots or attacks without them getting the chance to retaliate, or even having the energy to retaliate for that matter. And where else can we go? There's a path downstairs that... No, what's further funny to me is the fact that, yeah, we go back upstairs. Excuse me there. I think this is the way we need to... No, it's the other way. Yeah, so what's further funny to me is the fact that we, of all people, have been asked to raid Daggerfall's massive dungeons, while... Yeah, I suppose this takes us back to the place that we wanted to get to anyway, so might as well go there. Yeah, and this time around we go here to cross over to the other side and check out anything that might be in between, here and there. Like this majestic orc, not majestic orc, orc warlord here. excuse me there for another second. There should be a secret door here. And this time around it has no loot. Should be some loot right in the middle here. Excuse me. Really? I was super close to it, but you didn't let me pick it up. 64 gold pieces and nothing else of value. An orc warlord right here. You're stuck on the door, aren't you? Down with you. Sometimes when enemies get too close to the walls, they tend to get glitched into it. Not scratched sometimes, every single time. It doesn't matter if it's a walking type enemy or a flying type enemy. But actually, flying type enemies are immune to it. Okay, I need to take you out. I hope you wouldn't mind that. Okay, thank you. Ooh, no, this is something else altogether. Oh, this is the treasury. This is the treasury. We finally found it. I'm so excited to have found it. I thought we had to take like underwater routes and stuff. Huh. Maybe I don't remember the guide that I read as much. Because this is most certainly not an underwater route. I hear something else that I've heard before. Late. I didn't go through your inventory in its entirety. So yeah, we need to now figure out how to disable these lasers. That's like the real challenge of this section right here. I'm just gonna walk around it. Map the entire place out. No way to get to the top. You'll have to rely on the levitate spell. And look at the depth of this, sheer depth of this thing. I can certainly see what you meant when you said huge room. This room is huge. Let me just check you for any loot that you might be carrying. Anything worthwhile, apart from gold, that is. Because for me, gold holds no more value. I guess there are multiple ways to this place. At least I'm hoping. If this sends me into another large dungeon crawl, I'll just forsake it and come back. This better end in just a room with a lever. Is what I'll say. I see you there. This vampire was fast. How these guys are fast? Well, sometimes these guys have good loot. I like the gown you have on you. Only gold, nothing else. Somebody open this door. Excuse me? Okay, first off. Secondly, yeah, I don't need it anymore. But yeah, heal true, levitation, no. This is shock. Free action, I need free action right now. Next time onwards, I'm just gonna use the boots in my inventory. Excuse me again. Free action. I don't know why I'm still carrying around potions of slow falling. Those are useless. Resist fire, free action right here. Battle mage died. These guys can paralyze you, which is unfair. Oh, that's the underwater area that these guys are talking about. And I think that's another... Okay, that's a spell sword. Daedric sword, which would have been amazing, but... Okay, so right now we're at the very bottom of this place here. So I suppose that's where we're supposed to be headed. I mean, it's not technically underwater. Yet, at least. I just fear I might have used up all my potions of water breathing and water walking. I hope not. Well, I do have potions of water breathing here, but I think I've got a lot of them stacked up by now. Water walk right here. And let's go down. Let's go down the space. And we'll flip as many levers as we can, and hopefully that'll do something to our advantage. Lots of slaughter fish in this area. And they make a god awful noise. Where's this thing coming out? Oh, just out the other side. Okay, okay. I see what you did there. So we went down. Did we go down that way? We did not. No. We went down that way, which is towards the north, but the one on the right, so we'll go down this way now. Whoever. Oh, you're just a sorcerer that's almost totally immersed in water, just like me. No, these look amazing, but unfortunately, I've got better loot on me right now, so I'll not use them. This did not lead us anywhere either. It in fact brought us out the second east entrance. So right now we have already mapped these four entrances. What we need to map are the two entrances to the west and to the south. So let us start off with the western entrances, the one on the left first. There's like a level which takes us further down below. Oh, okay. It's not actually a level, it's just... Really? We need... Fine, water walking, you can have it. Or... Well, levitation also works, to be honest. It's like, without water walking, this guy won't work. So that just brings me out of the western tunnels. It's just like a loop with a trap in the middle. So I suppose what's left now is the routes to the south. So let us go check them out then. Okay. Water breathing. I mean, I could min-max it by letting it subside significantly before I pop one in, but I like to just go ahead and do it when I have the chance. I say Trunak died. And there's a water wheel here, which we hit. I do not know what it is going to do, but here's to hoping that whatever it does is quite productive. And this side, it's just a slaughterfish. Does it have anything though? No, just some chains. I wonder if these chains do anything. It teleports you. Spell sword died. I'm just going to rest here until I'm fully healed. You know, that it actually opened up that window over there, and that might just be the totem that we're looking for, along with other kinds of loot. So let's go ahead and save in the emergency slot here. Pop in like a potion of levitation. I was thinking about saving in the woods is a slot back then, but okay, this is just some odd loot. And 288 pieces of gold, I welcome that. I'm not going to say no to that, but this is not exactly why I came here. Ooh, it also unlocked like this entire upper section. Okay. I wonder what that did. Yes, I'll come to you. I'll come to you. You don't need to try and hit me that hard. When the potion of levitation is about to end, I'll just go ahead and... Okay, I want that potion. Pop in another. I'll just go ahead and pop in another. I think this is how we do it. We have already taken that loot. That might just be the Totem of Tiber Septim that we're looking for. Unless it's not. Okay, I don't know what that is. probably the totem then. Okay, what can we drop then? About, I guess our gold is all that we can drop. 992 pieces, alright, if you say so. We'll drop that much gold and... Okay. Like, this is honestly the part of the game that sucks the most. I guess we'll get rid of all the flowers and stuff that we have. That should open up some more. Oh yeah, we had a lot of them. The thing is... Okay, that might just be the Totem of Tiber Septim then. So I suppose. We got 732 pieces of gold. And how do we get out of here now, is the question. A voice in your head intones, "You are Grimfangs. You are my new host. Know this now and resolutely. You are not worthy to carry the Totem of Tiber Septim. Only those of his bloodline may carry me. I will give you a year and a day to accomplish this." Well, thanks for the word of confidence, I guess. But I need to figure out a way out of here now. That's what I need to do. And... apparently I'm right here. But what way did I use to get in here, is the question. Okay, all the way up there, was it? Seemingly yes. Seemingly yes. It was all the way up here. To get out of this chamber, I mean. Unless that's just my imagination. I think this is the route we took to come here. Yes, it was. So I guess we need to head up this ramp and then further up this ramp and take this left here. Alright. Let me just go ahead and save in this slot here. The dragon, yes, this is where we came from. Yes, it is indeed where we came from. Now, there is a path up there that we have not explored, but I am not entirely too eager to explore it. It might be a shortcut, but I would rather stick to the path that we have already traveled, rather than the path that we are yet to travel. Of all the places where... well, it could be the Totem of Tiber Septim, where the actual throne room could be. I did not expect it to be here, of all places, to be honest. And I think, actually we can go down here. Can't we? Yes, I do suppose we can go down here. And when we get here, what do we do now? Am I in the wrong place? I think we're at the wrong place. No, this is not where we're supposed to go. Unless this is the way. No, this is not the way. This is actually the way. This is actually the way to it, but I'm just having trouble figuring out where to go exactly. Because where I want to reach is that section, which essentially enables us to get to the dam. You know, the main chamber, the main Daggerfall area. Yes, right there. So in order to get there, how do we get there is the question. Like, I think we need to... No, that's not the place. Yes, this is the place right here. So, we are supposed to take this route here. And... to get there, there's like a hole in the wall that we need to get to. And to get to the hole in the wall, we essentially need to keep heading this way. No, heading that way will not solve anything for us. Do we go this way then? That apparently also does not do anything for us. Except for bring us out here. This is like a maze of its own. So I'm not even eager to address it. You know what? Let's just go back. I know like a better route. I know a better route through this mess. Said Grimfangs. And yeah, that's where we go and that's where we drop down. And then we head straight. Yes, we head straight. Because this was the place with the lock. And this brings us out into the main chambers. Now we can actually give it to Gothryd himself right here. But of course we will not be giving it to Gothryd. I have honestly made my decision already. I will be covering it in this video itself. And yeah, I just want to sort of I pondered it over. I will of course be getting at least a letter from Daggerfall, sorry, Varest, if not Daggerfall, but yeah, I was primarily stuck between giving the letter to, what's his name, excuse me there again, not the letter but rather the Totem of Tiber Septim to either the Emperor, Uriel Septim, out of loyalty and our friendship to the Emperor, or to Gotwalk so that he may carve out a space for his people. But given that Gotwalk was indeed involved in the death of King Lysandus and he did not actually stop it, try to stop it like he claims he did, it would be foolish to hand it over to him. As for his own area, as for a place for the Osimo, I think that is a noble cause and we can pretty much entrust Emperor Uriel Septim the 7th to, you know, carving out a space for all the Osimo. So yeah, we're gonna hand it over to the Emperor via Lady Brisienna, of course. So to that end, let me just travel around, waste some time. And I'm in Daggerfall, I suppose this would be the furthest place that we can get to. More north, find more north, more north. It would take 30 days by ship. Let's go. I think that would be enough time for me to get any sort of missives about this thing. Yep, I have assassins after me. Hand over the totem or we'll slaughter you where you stand. Well, are you going to give it to us or make us take it from you? Then we'll just have to take it. I know. God, are you going to do anything about this assassin that's after my life? Ooh, this looks amazing. But yeah, despite the way it looks, it does not actually give you any boost to your armor. Successful backstab. You do not have a lot of life left in you. So yeah, these assassins are all being sent to us by His Majesty. Another one. Three of them at the same time. All being sent to us by, well, what's his name? Who are you? Ah, I guess it's because I installed the Red Guards mod. Anyway, so yeah, all of these people are being sent to us courtesy of King, what's his name? We got a letter from somebody. Bearing the mark of something, I sort of missed that. This is the Totem of Tiber Septim. And let us use this. Noble Grimfangs. Yeah, Edvir. Noble Grimfangs, my ears have picked up rumors that you are searching for the Totem of Tiber Septim. I too have hunted for this wondrous artifact for many years. Should you find it, I would pay you a healthy ransom, enough to buy your own ship. I will match or exceed any price that Gothryd or Akorathi might offer. Never forget your real friends, King Edvir of Verest. See, the last line here is pretty much what's confirmed my convictions to give it to the Emperor, to my true friend. So yeah, it was King Edvir who was sending all the assassins after us, and that this is Mornoth. And let us just go ahead and waste some more time traveling around pointlessly. A heavily cloaked figure shuffled towards you. As you prepare to defend yourself, a gnarled green hand shoots forth with the letter. Stunned, you do nothing as the figure shuffles away. King of Worms, is it? Well, I suppose. And we apparently got another letter here. Grimfangs, if you're reading this, you must have gotten the totem and escaped from the dungeons of Castle Daggerfall. I'm in Grimdale Moor of Verest at the Tigard residence. Bring the totem there as soon as possible. Grimfangs, you are not orcish. How could you possibly understand what it is like? My people are treated as barbarians, slaughtered upon sight. Is it so unusual that we respond in kind? Violence begets violence. I aspire to raise my race from the mire. I will bring them to equal standing with the other races of Tamriel. To do this, I must have the Totem of Tiber Septim. I will not insult you by promises that no blood will be shed. I do swear by my crown and by my heirs, I shall not attempt to hold sway beyond the borders of Orsinium. My goal is not to conquer Tamriel, but to create the Orcish homeland. I am in possession of an artifact that I am sure you would want to possess. If it is yours, it is yours if you but give me the Totem of Tiber Septim, Godwalk, Warlord and King. And I can certainly see the sway in his voice. I mean, a hand grips your wrist from behind, spinning. You open your mouth to shout for the guards. A skeletal hand stuffs a letter into your mouth. The heavily robed skeleton raises your wrist and turns away, unnoticed. Releases your wrist and turns away, unnoticed by other passerbys. Well, let's hear it from the King of Worms as well. Grimfangs, I will soon have the Totem of Tiber Septim in your hands. It is foreseen in the stars, and I have read them. Know you this, all of mortal stature, and are filled with pride and greed. To give the totem to any of them is to let loose mortal vanity upon this world. They will destroy the very thing they covet. I have no earthly desires. I have no mortal pride, no petty greed. Only one such as I can wield the totem safely, for I would take it into the Aetherius and leave behind this earthly shell. So long as the totem exists, it is a danger to all of Tamriel. Bring me the totem, and I will safeguard the world. I will not offer you gold or gems. I will offer you what only I can give, fame. Your reputation throughout Tamriel will soar. Lord of the Necromancers, King of the Wombs. Well, every single time that I try to travel, somebody stops me and hands me a letter. I guess I'm pretty popular in this game, aren't I? But anyway, my mind is made. I mean, I can certainly see. A letter floats through the air toward you. Strangely, nobody else seems to notice it. The letter tucks itself into your back. Medora? Most likely. Grimfangs. Centuries ago, Tiber Septim ruled the land and forged an empire with great Numidium. The secret of Numidium's power lies in its heart. Carried within the Mantella, it is the heart of Tiber Septim's battle mage. It is my heart. It is my Mantella. It is my totem. It belongs to me and to none other. I have won and lost an empire. I have no desire to tamper further with mortal affairs. I have in my possession Necromancer's amulet, one of the world's greatest artifacts. I wonder why the King of Worms doesn't have it. You may have it in exchange for the totem. My most loyal agent will await your arrival in Burgwall Moor of Verest at the House of Tibella. So I think they've got two options if we go to Burgwall Moor. Either the Underking's agent, or what's her name? Lady Brisienna. But yeah, I can certainly see the charm of Bortwog, the way he elaborates things, the way he puts things. His speech, he's quite eloquent in his speech, and which is like a pretty big thing for an orc, to be honest. I mean, I don't want to be racist that way, but yeah. But at the same time, I don't really trust this Underking or the King of Worms, given how one of them is literally engaged in necromancy, while the other one... More assassins after us. While the other one is essentially, well... we don't know anything about the other one, actually. Apart from the fact that people vilify him for no reason. Alright, I see a dead person. I was in info mode all this time. I'm just looking for, like, Daedric gauntlets, and if none of them have it, then... boo-hoo. God, what are you doing? These guys literally attacked me on the street. 1,020 gold pieces. Now that I've put away all that crap that I was carrying, I've got space for a lot of gold now. And all of them, of course, I can't carry anymore at this juncture. Fine. Whatever works. Unfortunately, I cannot rest here until I'm healed. Why did I come to Vadist? I was not supposed to come to Vadist. Where was I supposed to go? Sorry about that. This one, I suppose? No, this one? Excuse me. So yeah, it was not Birchwall Moor, but Grimdale Moor. Anyhow, I suppose off we go to Grimdale Moor then. No, for toss. Ships can't swim on land. Pretty sure there would be some more of those guys waiting to ambush me here. I would be surprised if they weren't. None? Well, that's a surprise. But yeah, King Edward is the one who's sending all those, you know, assassins after us. And then he has the audacity to call himself our friend. Well, I suppose that is just how assassins go. How treacherous folks go. Now, that's just the thing about Varys as well, like, the entire apple seems to be rotten, and I don't know what Berenzia is doing in the middle of it. Considering her close, the nature of her close relationship with Tiber Septim, I honestly don't know what she's doing there. Which case did I... Oh my god, I need to read it again. Master's the residence, right. Excuse me, I would like to talk to any of you. Master's the residence. People? Yeah, Lady Brisienna, that works. I know nothing about that. I mean, that's typically a general idea. Nobody should know that she's there, but I guess we're just gonna have to look at Master's the residence then. It's not too far to the northeast if you don't mind walking. Alright. Northeast, over here. Somewhere in this general vicinity, apparently. I don't know how we got so popular with these folks, but yeah, we did. We got really popular with these guys. But she did say a little ways northeast, so I suppose it cannot be this close unless this is Majesty's residence, though it is not. Is this it? This is part of the same place. It's just a residence, a huge residence at that. And somebody's rich. I doubt this is Majesty's residence either. Let's take the chance to ask somebody where the Master's Lee residence is. What is that thing? Like this wall in the middle. What is this? A Excuse me? Huh, interesting. Yeah, Master's the residence piece, or rather, Lady Brisienna. Ways north of here. Is this the Master's Thief residence? It did say a ways north of here, so I'm assuming it'll take time for us to get there. Apparently not the Master's Thief residence. Master's Thief residence? Grim Deal Moor gear. Name of place gear. Master's Thief residence. It's quite a large residence on top. Like, everything considered. Where's the door though? Did I miss it? I don't think I did. Where is the door? Yeah, right here. Alright, dialogue mode. A jolly voice says, "Welcome to my home!" Alright, now time to search for Lady Brisienna, wherever she might be. Some cabinets there. Excuse me? Like, double layered doors there. Alright, time to go poking through somebody's home. Which I'm sure they'll appreciate. That's a beautiful painting, sir. Did you make it yourself? This place is a maze. How does someone live here, let alone navigate in this thing that they call a house? I remember going to one such house through... I think this opens up in the balcony. Yes, yes it does. It would be strange to see Lady Brisienna waiting for us here. Voice says, come on in. Of course it would say come on in. Because why not? What harm have we ever done to this person? Right. And that would be... I don't know her name, but yeah, that's the jolly person. Belladonna Hearthfield. At whom? Who's whom? Lady Brisienna is going to say, so I'm assuming that she's also part of the Blades then. Your Emperor will be most grateful. The Totem could have started a civil war in the wrong hands. Thank you, Grimfangs. Now you must away to Nulfaga. She holds the key to the Mantella. Free the Mantella and the Emperor controls great Numidium through the Totem. Oh well! At this point I sort of am beginning to regret my decision. Giving so much power to one person does not seem right, to be honest, but at the same time, the Imperial family's goal has always been to unify Tamriel, and they are very, very secular, and they promote equality in whatever they do. They were pretty much the first people who, even though they campaigned into Black Marsh, they were also the first people who actually appointed Argonians into officiating positions. And if anybody, I'm quite certain that Imperial rule will be the one thing that will benefit not just the Iliac Bay or High Rock, but all of Tamriel, to be honest. So I think, even though I might be taking a gamble here, which I might live to regret later on in my life, I think this is essentially the right choice to make. The unmistakable voice of Nulfaga speaks softly into your head. I see that the Totem has found its way into the hands of someone with royal blood. I think it is time you paid me another visit here in your dungeon, Grimfangs. Your work is not yet done. Well, now that's something. That's something, alright. Over. That is our cue to actually... Ooh, look at that. That's like a banner of Daggerfall. Interesting. But yeah, that's pretty much our cue that the final quest has been set into motion. So... Probably should have made a save before I gave them any of that thing. But yeah, as for this video, this is it. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, thank you so much for sticking around until the end. Now I have made a save in save 2 over there, and I think I'll preserve it. And I'm sort of curious as to what Godfog would do with the Totem. And I sort of want to like give him the totem and then just teleport to the quest objective in you know, try doing that at least, or if it's not possible then I'll just try and use some cheats to hack my way there or whatever. And just to show you guys the ending of what would happen if Godfog would have gotten that, his words have swayed me for the good, or for good or for bad. Anyhow, as for this video, this is it. We obtained the Totem of Tiber Septim and we gave it to one of his heirs, Uriel Septim the 7th. And I think if anybody, that is the rightful person to be holding the totem. Now just to break the emotion for a bit here, that is just what I choose for this character's playthrough. And I mean, I would be choosing different people in subsequent characters with subsequent characters, but let us see how that goes. Anyhow, so the next time we come back, we will be covering the final quest of this game, which involves us going to Nulfaga and, well, retrieving the heart of the Golem Numidium, essentially. And yeah, that's it. Until then, take care, fare thee well, fellow things.